What's up, Insomniacs? Your boy Frankie D here, back with another edition of Insomnia Movie Reviews! Oh yeah! Oh yeah! Today we're tackling the summer blockbuster Batman vs. Superman Dawn of Justice. Now yet, this is another sequel to a movie that I haven't seen yet. I have not seen Superman Man of Steel, and that is what this is a sequel to. While this tries to be a standalone sequel, it relies heavily on the actions of the first film to tell its story. Rightly so, it's a sequel, and I don't know why I hate sequels on here that I haven't seen already, but I don't know, I just gotta keep going with I'm going. So the synopsis of the movie is this: you know, Superman and Batman are in a clash. Batman doesn't like Superman because he thinks he can cause a whole bunch of destruction. He's caused lives to be hurt and the many lives that he has saved over time. Batman does not like the supreme power that Superman can hold, and he wishes to put an end to it. Now this movie is very much action-packed. It's very slow in the first third of the movie, but the last two thirds really pick up the action and progress the story. Although I feel like the storyline was weak in this film and that many people will be excited to see it just because it's Batman and Superman, I feel that a lot was missed from this movie. It was hyped up so much that everybody wanted to see it, which was great, and it made a lot of money at the box office, but the storytelling was sloppy and lazy at best. Again, the best part of this film, in my opinion, was Jesse Eisenberg's portrayal as Lex Luthor. He does it in such a menacing sort of psychological way that makes you seem like he's crazy, but at the same time stays completely in control and knows exactly what he's doing. That's Lex Luthor we have not seen. We've seen the all-powerful side, and we've seen maybe a little bit of a human side, but we haven't seen those two worlds merge, and I believe Jesse Eisenberg did that flawlessly. Now, if you know Insomnia Movie Reviews, we're going to talk about some stomach magic in this film. Now, stomach magic, for those who have not seen these videos before, is that one thing in the movie that I can attach myself to, and I can just get that feeling in my gut to know what's good. Again, the stomach magic in this film was Jesse Eisenberg's portrayal of Lex Luthor. I could not feel anything for any other character in this film. Although, another part of stomach magic for this film was Wonder Woman, because she was amazing. Now, I have brought back Maverick Walker to give another review. If you guys would like me to stop, please leave a comment, but you know, I like his opinion sometimes, and now here's Maverick to give you his opinion on Batman vs. Superman Dawn of Justice.
What's up, internet? This is your boy Maverick Walker here giving you his two cents about this film. Now the title says Batman vs. Superman Dawn of Justice. That was anything but what this film was. It was a build-up to nothing. It was a build-up to a little spat between two spoiled brats. That's what I gotta say, it was a spat between two spoiled brats. Yeah, it's a rhyme. We rhyme on this show. But now when Batman and Superman do become friends, the reason is so asinine, it took me completely out of this film, and I had to go out to the first immediate bar and grab me a Budweiser, chug it, and come back. Even though they didn't want me to come back in after I had my first beer, they said, you already paid for your ticket, you left the theater, and you can't come back in. I still snuck back in. Had to buy another ticket, but I got back in. This is America. I can do what I want.
Thank you, Maverick. That was really something. That was really something. Well, final thoughts on this film are, it wasn't a great film. The special effects were something. Like I said, Jesse Eisenberg is the best part of this movie. If you go see it, please keep that in mind. I don't want to take anything away from the film's creators, because a lot of money was put into this film, and a lot of money was made off this movie. DC just cannot hit the mark the same way Marvel can, and I think that's just something to do with the writing. I don't know. I don't know what's going on with the DC universe, but we are excited to see Suicide Squad, and hopefully with the addition of Suicide Squad, DC can redeem themselves. Now it's time to ask the question, Mr. Frank, how many Franks would you give this movie out of 5?
I'll give this film 3 out of 5 Franks.
You heard it here. 3 out of 5 Franks. Another homemade ballpark, y'all. And that does it for this edition of Insomnia Movie Reviews. If you like this video, please hit that like button. Please leave a comment down below about what movie you want me to review next. Also, please share this film with your friends, enemies, coworkers. I don't care, as long as you get the name of Insomnia Movie Reviews out there. Now, I don't know about you, Night Owls, but this Insomniac's gonna try to get some sleep. Have a good night.